In the new age of open source era, most of the softwares which we use are free and open source, which basically means you can try things for free, for learning, or for a proof of concept. This applies to most of the tools which we use in the technology landscape. Continuous integration is no different to that. If you have been following my channel, you know that I have been doing a lot of videos on continuous integration and continuous deployment using Jenkins and other deployment tools inside Amazon. In this video, we are going to see how we can integrate with TravisCI, the free open source project, if you have a public repo inside GitHub. Let's get started.
Press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss any update from Tech Primers.
TravisCI is a continuous integration platform which you can use for integrating with your GitHub projects and get instant feedbacks about the continuous integration and the deployment which you have configured for your repo. If you look at TravisCI.org, it just says test and deploy with confidence, easily sync your GitHub projects with TravisCI and you'll be testing your code in minutes. So basically, TravisCI provides a platform where your code is going to be checked out and then your continuous integration is going to happen based on whatever you tell TravisCI to do. So basically, you can control the whole TravisCI using a configuration file, which is a YAML file, and TravisCI does whatever you have mentioned inside this particular file. So this is how the TravisCI build looks like. We are going to do that in a while, but let's see what are the different options which TravisCI provides. The good part about TravisCI is if you have an open source project, then it is completely free. So what are the different features TravisCI provides? It provides a quick setup. I'm just going to show you the setup live. And also it has build views. You can see the build logs. You can have builds for pull requests. You can have pre-installed database services, which Travis provides. You can have automated deployments after the build is successful. For example, let's say your build is successful and your tests are run and then they are also successful. You can deploy them into your runtime. Every time we run the build, it starts off by creating a new VM. So it's always clean and it checks out your code every single time and then builds your project from scratch. It also supports Mac and Linux. So if you, let's say, have a library which you want to run on a Mac server, you can specifically define what kind of server or the infrastructure you need for the runtime. These are the different branching flows or build flows. For example, let's say we have a GitHub project. If we commit our changes into GitHub, there will be a hook which will trigger TravisCI saying that my GitHub has been updated with a new change. Please build this particular repo. And now TravisCI will pick up all the artifacts, build based on whatever configuration you provide Travis to, and then finally it can deploy to a runtime like Heroku, and ultimately it can send notifications to a channel like Slack. So this is a Slack channel which gets notification based on your build feedback. Let's say if the build fails, you get a notification back to Slack and you can act upon these builds. So that way you get instant feedback on your continuous integration and continuous deployment pipeline. So this is the whole branch build pipeline which TravisCI has. It also has a pull request pipeline. Let's say you have raised a pull request to a default branch. Now, again, GitHub sends a notification to TravisCI saying there is a new change on this particular branch and it is a pull request. So now, again, you can configure your Travis based on the pull request branch and you can check if the build succeeds, and the build succeed notification will be passed on back to GitHub. So basically, when you're reviewing your code, you know whether the build has succeeded or not. These are similar features which are provided by any source code repository platform which has Git based ones, and especially with GitHub, which is completely free, having TravisCI is an add-on advantage when you have public repositories. So if you have a GitHub account and if you have public repository, you're free to try TravisCI. Enough of getting to know the features of TravisCI, right? Let's get started by creating a new repo and let's integrate that with TravisCI and then try how easy it is for us to set up a integration between a GitHub repo and to a TravisCI account. So I'm going to create a new repository called as TravisCI example. So there is an option called sign in with GitHub. If you click on sign up, it again shows you that I'm going to sign in with my GitHub account. So if I click on this, it asks me to now authorize and provide all the details of my GitHub account. So for example, here it's the first one says, I need read-only access for the organization and the teams. And also I need the read-write access for commits so that TravisCI can commit back if it needs to, and it can read while checking out the code. Also, we are providing it access to do deployments. So if let's say we have credentials stored inside TravisCI, now we are giving full authority to TravisCI to deploy artifacts into your runtime. It also reads your email address, which is the only personal information part. Again, we are saying that configure my webhooks so that automatically GitHub will send notification to TravisCI. So this last part will help us in automatically triggering the build without even going and manually clicking on the build now option. So I'm going to click on the authorize TravisCI. This is going to take me to the TravisCI account dashboard. So we are getting a notification saying great news, we have successfully synchronized and it has loaded our repositories. See that it's showing all the repository which I had. If I click on the dashboard, I should be able to see some getting started. So if you see here, it says my builds, there are no builds, there are no active repositories. Okay, so there are some documentation links as well. If you click on the documentation, you can go through how you can use the YAML file to configure the build configuration. So we're not going to do that. Let me create this repo quickly so that we can create a TravisCI repository. So in order to put some Java code, I'm going to create a Spring Boot project, which we always like. Right, I'm going to create a simple Spring Boot project called TravisCI. I'm going to call this as TravisCI example. And let's add two dependencies. One is the actuator and the other one is the Spring Web Starter. That's all. I'm going to download this project. I'll also unzip it into my terminal. So let me maximize the terminal. So I've unzipped the project here. So there is a folder called TravisCI example. So this has nothing ls-la. If you see here, there is only .maven file. There is a .kitigno file. That's it. So we don't have any other files here. Let me go to the project which we created and let's add git into this particular project. I'll just say git init. I'm going to add git repository. I'll just say, so by default it doesn't understand my username, so I had to do this particular option. Done. So we are going to add all the files and we are going to commit all the files. Now we have committed all the files. The other part which is missing is we need a TravisCI configuration file. So the file for triggering the TravisCI is called travis.yaml. So we need to create it with .travis.yaml. This is going to have the configuration details of what needs to be done during the build phase. So TravisCI has a configuration YAML which we are going to use. So by default, we are going to use the language Java. So you can just say language Java. And what is the runtime we need? We need the runtime JDK. So I'm going to say open JDK 8. So this defines what is the runtime we need. If let's say you need Java 11, you can just mention open JDK 11. So I'm going to use Java 8. That's why I'm defining open JDK 8. That's it. So we don't have to mention anything else. If you want notifications to be sent to your mail, you can just say notifications email and you can define your email address. So this way you will get notifications to your mailbox automatically, or you can configure the Slack channel so that you can get instant notification directly to your Slack. I'm not going to show the Slack right now, but I'll just show you how to configure the build configurations. For example, there is a field called script. You can define the script to define what needs to be run. So since this is a Maven project, I'm going to run Maven clean install. That's the task I want to run. That way I know my build phase is going to use this particular task for building my artifacts or generating my artifacts. Now let's save this file and commit this. The push is successful. Now let's go to the GitHub repo and check if the push has got succeeded. Yep, I see the files. I see a Travis file. There is no README, but I'll add the README after the video recording is completed so that you can follow some steps and then leverage it for configuring it in your account. So we have added few things. We are using the Java runtime, we are using the JDK, OpenJDK 8, and we have given some default step. Now let's go to the Travis dashboard and configure this particular project. There is this option here, which is plus. I'm clicking on this plus option, and you can see that there are a lot of different repositories it shows. Right now I don't see the Tech Primers organization because that is where we created this particular account. This is logged in via my personal account, and Tech Primers is an organization. So I'm going to say review and add my authorized organization. So if I click on that, it's going to say, okay, I'm just clicking on the grant. So this will give me access for the Tech Primers organization. Now I will be able to look at the repositories from the TravisCI so that I can add that into this particular dashboard. So let's try. After refreshing the repositories, we can see the organization account. Now if I click on the organization account, it is going to show me all the repositories for this particular organization. Now we added our repository called Travis-CI. Let's wait for it. Yeah, so this is the repository. Now let's go to this particular repository. Let's see what is happening. Build history, nothing is there in the build history. So nothing is showing in the build history because we have enabled the GitHub Tech Primers organization only after committing it. So right now there is an option called activate repository. So you can activate your repository by clicking this below option. I'm going to click on the activate option. This is going to explore my project and then see if there is a .travis.yaml file. Since this is the first time, it's going to go and scan my repository. So if I see that, what is it doing? Is there any build history? No build history. It just says, it shows up the repository, but it doesn't have any other option. So I'm going to click on the trigger build option so that we can get this build going. So if I click on the trigger build option, this is going to now identify if there is a Travis.yaml and it's going to trigger the build. See that already we can see the job log configuration. So first it says job received. There is a queuing option. And then finally it says booting VM. Every build which happens inside TravisCI runs on a VM. So every stage which we define, right now we have not defined any stage. The only stage which we defined is the build stage, which is nothing but this. The script Maven clean install, that is the only stage. So right now it's going to create a VM. So the VM got created and it's going to run that particular stage called clean install. So let's look at that in the log file. See that the code has got checked out and it's running this particular stage called Maven install and then doing whatever we have told it. Right, so Maven install is going to download all the Maven artifacts for the Spring Boot project and it's going to run. Now let's open the Travis file and add some stages. So let's see how we can add stages. So stages can be defined as jobs. So the configuration for that is like this: jobs include, and then you can have a stage, and the name of the stage can be test. For example, in our case, let's call it as test, and I want to run some task for it. So I'm going to say Maven clean test, run some Maven clean test for my next stage. Now let's go back to our build. See that the build got passed because it did a Maven clean install and it was successful. See that the command Maven clean install exited with zero, which basically means our build got succeeded. And you can see different logs from here. You can also see the configuration file on what was the configuration file for this particular repository. See that this is the configuration file which we committed. And you can even copy this Travis.yaml. In our case, now we are going to add a new stage, which is nothing but test. Let's see how does that look like. So I'm going to say commit-am update Travis.yaml. So this is needs to be pushed. The moment I click on git push, my build should automatically get triggered because I already built it once, right? And I also have configured the GitHub hooks. So now click on the repo. Now we should see, let's click on branch. See that my build number 2 got received already and the VM is getting started. So let the VM get started and then let's see what is happening. These are the startup logs for the VM. Notice that it's installing OpenJDK 8 based on the configuration we provided here. And it's running something. Let's come back to build history. Let's say branches. We have only master branch. Let me go to started. And first it should run one Maven clean install, and then it needs to run some Maven clean test. So let me go back to the end. So it's running some Maven clean test. See that it says Maven clean test exited with zero. This basically tells us that it has run our Maven clean test as well. And you can see that from the logs here. So this is how you can use TravisCI to get a continuous integration platform up and running within minutes on a GitHub project, which is completely open sourced. So this is a public project. You can clone this particular GitHub repo, go to github.com/trekprimers, and you can find TravisCI example from there. You can get the TravisCI.yaml, configure TravisCI in your account, and you can get the build up and running. You can try a lot of things from here. If you want to automatically deploy, you can add stages. Let me know if you want me to make a video on how to deploy TravisCI, and do let me know where do you want me to deploy this particular sample artifact to. I hope you found this particular video interesting. As always, if you like the video, go ahead and like it. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, go ahead and subscribe to it. Meet you again in the next video. Thank you very much.